G'day everyone. I ran out of beer a while back and had to buy some commercial beer and stuff like all that. And I had a brown ale on tap, but it's just too, it's not a session beer, it's about 7%, so you can only drink like three or four of these things and you're starting to get shitters. Anyway, so I brewed a Kid and Kilo, just a Cooper's Real Ale, some Marisotta, whole heap of Cascade hops, and just the kit yeast. I just used the kit yeast. It's been in the keg for a couple of months now. It's ready now to drink. So at the end of this video, I'll throw some videos up like I use, some pictures up like I usually do. It's processed stuff. It'll only take a couple of minutes, sit through it. And I'll talk through this tasting at the end of it. Okay, see you in about 2 minutes. All right, so this is what we got. We've got a Cooper's Real Ale tin. We have about a kilo and a half of Maris Otter, a little bit of Crystal 60, and a little bit of chocolate, about 50 grams odd. We've got some Bachelor Bush Honey, about 450 grams. The kit yeast, like I said, that's what I'm going to use in this one, ferment it quite low. Heat some water, we've done this before, we'll heat some water, add a bit of gypsum to that, calcium sulfate, just helps in the mash attenuation, and it helps lower the pH of my water. And I do brew in a bag, that's just the bag straining out. You've seen brew in a bag before, this is the way that I do it, on stovetop. I've had to boil over two pots because I ended up with a little bit more than what I needed, but I poured them all into one pot. I added hops, Cascade every 5 minutes for 30 minutes. All right, sort of like a Dogfish Head IPA type deal. Okay, that is it, and I've fermented at about 17 degrees centigrade I think it was just on 3 weeks. And that's it. Yep. Okay. Thanks for watching that. Here it is. Look how cloudy that is. I think it's because I didn't put any Irish moss or Whirlflock or anything like that in. But the Cascade just comes out. Ooh, yeah. Straight up. It's very citrusy, fruity. Fairly bitter, but it's not a bad little beer. It's got a little bit of a cascadey aroma and flavour to it, but not strong, not overpowering. So that's what I got there. The crystal malt sort of comes through on it. Look, when I'm doing those batches just for a little bit of extra beer, I just really put them together and slap them together. The process, look, doesn't really bother me too much. I enjoy my old grain brewing because the process is a lot more in depth. In saying that, I'll do partials. I'll do kit and kilo, or I'll do whatever, just to get that, get some beer into the kegs sometimes. and it's good enough. It's not going to win a competition at all. However, cheers. Up your bum. That honey doesn't even come through. I think that just fermented out completely. Anyway, thanks for watching. My brew stand build. It's coming up. Probably not going to film the brew stand build itself. I think what I'll do is I'll film my next brew session. But I've got to go and get some more base malt. I'm going to do some English bitters and stuff like that. And some English ales, leading into next year. Something easy to drink, mild, something easy to drink, something easy to